Hey guys, how is it going? Welcome back to another episode of For the Classical Guitarist. If you're new here, my name is John, and if you like what you see, hopefully you consider subscribing to the channel and checking out more videos of mine and ringing the bell to be notified of when there is a new video. Anyway, let's get started. Okay, so as I'm sure you can guess by the title of the video, I'm going to be talking about and showing you some clips where they show classical guitar being portrayed in TV shows. So the first clip is from Star Trek The Next Generation. Check it out. Okay, so as a guitarist, my main thoughts are that, yeah, he's definitely not holding the guitar that well, honestly. The neck angle is really not that great, and so is the right arm placement. But again, this is a TV show, let's forgive that. It is pretty cool that he is showing you some music by Fransisco Tarrega. This one will be the Prelude No. 2 by him. And I think the big idea of the show, from what I got, from what I was reading a little bit about it, is that this character's name is Data, and he's supposed to be an android, and he can't actually feel or show emotions that well, at least from what I've gotten. And the idea of him playing this music like this, at least somewhat expressively, is kind of really showing who he is deep down. And you know, I do think that's pretty cool for someone to take the idea of classical guitar and use it to show someone showing emotion, showing some creativity. So, pretty cool for them, and thank you so much for picking a piece that's not super, super basic, like you'll see later in this video. This next one comes from the television show Jane the Virgin, and I only know a little bit about this show, but what I can tell you is that the guitar playing clip has nothing to do with the whole entire show. But here it is. Okay, so what I found interesting here is the guitar player being portrayed is the guitarist Charo. And what I found interesting is that that is actually her portraying herself in there. And she is a classical, I guess, more so a flamenco guitarist. But either way, she's a guitar player. At one point, she even studied under Andres Segovia. And as you can tell here, the guitar playing here when she's playing Recuerdos De La Alhambra just looks super, super fake. And I'm sure it is. And yes, I know that in a lot of these things, they obviously record the audio separately and then play over it. But I wonder why they just didn't have her play over it actually. Even the way she's holding the guitar looks kind of fake, and you can tell she's not really playing, at least I think she is. But for all we know, it's probably her playing on the actual thing that we're hearing. So I don't know. I thought it was interesting, but let me know what you think about that one in the comments. This next clip comes from the television show Grey's Anatomy, which is a show about doctors trying to become doctors. I guess more specifically surgeons trying to become surgeons. But anyway, as I'm sure you're going to see in a second, they're operating on somebody's brain, and then after they're done, they ask them to play guitar. Check this out.
Welcome back, Kyle. I showed you my moves, time to show us yours. All right, come on, your turn to freestyle.
Okay, so my first comment is how they called it freestyle. I don't know if I would call playing guitar of any style freestyle, but whatever, they're doctors. Anyway, so my big thing though is this. They picked one of the most basic pieces to play, and from what I got from this guy, he isn't really a classical guitarist, but they just wanted something, I guess, that sounded impressive, so they went with Asturias, of course, because that's the piece that everybody thinks is super hard on guitar when it's not actually crazy difficult. Anyway, as you can see here, the guitar playing again looks super, super fake. I mean, he does do a nice job of getting his left hand in the correct spot, but honestly, for someone who doesn't play guitar, because I'm pretty sure this actor doesn't, he did a nice job of getting himself set up, at least getting there. Okay, so to be honest, this next one, I actually have never seen the show before. I only know about it because somebody recommended it in the comments on another video of mine to check out, but this would be a clip from the television show The OA, and it's pretty early on in the show from what I got because it's on Netflix. Anyway, check it out, and I'll talk about it after. Thank you. Okay, so if you guys don't know, the piece that is being played here is the piece Danza Del Altiplano by Leo Brouwer. And any of you guys who follow my channel and follow what I've played before in the past probably know I play this piece, and I've actually played this piece for quite a while. So as someone who plays this piece, I can tell you that the person does a kind of okay job pretending to play it, but definitely doesn't actually play it. What I think is interesting is for this, they picked a very interesting version of this piece. I've never heard the piece being played this way. I didn't show all the clips, but in the beginning of it, they're actually doing this improvisatory thing, kind of leading up to it, and later on in the show. But that is pretty common, so I guess I do give them props for that. And honestly, it was pretty cool, because a lot of people who never heard music of Leo Brouwer got to hear this piece, and also got to check out classical guitar. One thing that I think is really cool about all of this is going to the YouTube video, where you can find some of these clips on YouTube, and just seeing the comment section, seeing how people are actually really interested in classical guitar music, seeing how many people actually want to know more about who played this piece and where else to hear it. I thought it was pretty cool, and that's definitely where I saw the most in this one, because it is being portrayed more in a performance spot, unlike the last clip, where it was just kind of more like a, hey, this is a cool thing to do, and then we're gonna cut out to some music by someone else. Definitely not a bad portrayal, but I'm just being super picky because I've played this piece for so long. Okay, so this last one isn't actually a television show, at least not in the same ways as the first four were, but I did want to include it in here because it is something that's on TV, so I guess it counts. And that would be a clip from the television series Australia Got Talent. And as I'm sure you can guess by the title, it's about people that have talent in Australia. Now, if you guys aren't too familiar with these kinds of shows, this is a contest kind of talent show where people go up and perform, very similar to American Idol, where you have judges and you also have a live audience. Okay, so as a classical guitarist like many of us who has played Asturias before, I'm not going to talk about this version of the piece other than it's an interesting version of the piece. I do think it's kind of his own audition. They do say it's his own arrangement of this famous piece. And you know, maybe it is. I do think there's been tons of other arrangements before, so I don't know why he would make his own. But I think for this setting, it kind of works. He definitely makes it sound a bit more flashy, a bit more exciting, you know. And yeah, that's pretty much it. What I do want to talk about is just his guitar. His guitar is a little bit weird. I don't really understand what it is or where he got it from. It definitely has like a much harsher sound than a traditional classical guitar. And for this, maybe it works. It does kind of give that more like guitarist rock star kind of show while still playing fingerstyle. But personally, I'm not in love with it. The thing that I think is great about this is that he's, again, just like a lot of these shows, is bringing classical guitar to people that normally haven't heard it. And because they've never heard it, this is like the coolest thing to them. And you know, good for him. So overall, when watching different kinds of things like this, I do think one thing that's really great about all of this is that people are bringing classical guitar, again, like I said, to people who normally don't hear it. And through television is one of the best ways to do it, because people just watch television, even if they're not looking to hear a guitar. And then sometimes when they hear it, they're like, wow, you know, that was really great. I'm gonna go ahead and check out more. So overall, yes, I don't think this guy played the best. I do think it was pretty cool that he made a flashier version of it. And again, he does show kind of what it is, kind of like being a classical guitar player, talking about nails. It's not in this video, but if you guys want to find it on YouTube, you guys probably can. But anyway, those are my overall thoughts. Anyway, if you're still here, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you guys found something interesting about this, and definitely don't judge the people in the videos too much, because again, they are doing something for our community by bringing classical guitar just to people who don't normally hear it. Anyway, that's all I have. So for now, I will see you guys in the next video. If you're new here, make sure to subscribe and check out more videos of mine. If you like this one, if you didn't, I guess don't. But anyway, I'll see you in the next one.